Hello children, I am back again with the next video from the chapter Principle of Inheritance and Variations. Now in this video we are going to talk about inheritance of two genes. I know that I have already discussed about the dihybrid cross in the previous videos, but there is a law which has been related to dihybrid cross. So I am going to show you again a bit of dihybrid cross and the law which has been related to this. So the law is independent assortment. Now I know that you have already done dihybrid cross and the way it should be drawn with the help of a Punnett square. Okay, so just giving a brief up of that dihybrid cross through this PPT. As you see, it is a cross between the two parents differing in two pairs of contrasting characters. So we have taken two parents, both are P, see, both of them are P, but you can see one has a shape which is round and the color is yellow. And the other one is wrinkled. You see, the shape is wrinkled and the color is green. So both of them have contrasting characters, and here round for shape and yellow for color. So round for shape is dominant and wrinkled for shape is recessive. Similarly, yellow for color is dominant and green for color is recessive. So we are discussing two traits at a time. One is the shape and the other is the color. Hence this cross is known as dihybrid cross. Now children, because we have taken parents to be homozygous round yellow. Now this means that homozygous means that the allele will be same. So the allele for shape, that is the allele for round, is capital R and capital R, and the allele for color yellow is capital Y, capital Y. Now why are both of them capital? Because it is a homozygous condition. Similarly, the recessive characters are also homozygous. So for wrinkled we took small r, and for green we took small y. Now you take it as small y because it is printed, so it has a different shape. If you see, it has a different shape than the capital I, so y. So this is small y. Now children, for F1 generation, the gametes formed will be only this. Now whether this R joins with this Y or the second R will join with the second Y, the gametes will always be same, that is capital R and capital Y. That means I will get four options and all the four options of the gamete will be same. So that is why we have not written them separately. I wrote only one gamete, or the figure contains only one gamete. Similarly here, because all the gametes, I will get four gametes and all of them will be same. So only one of them has been written here. Okay, so now we get these gametes. Now when these gametes will fuse together, I will get F1 generation, which will be heterozygous round yellow. Why heterozygous round yellow? Because one dominant allele and one recessive for shape. Similarly, one dominant, one recessive for color. So because the dominant alleles are present, that is why they will be able to express, and the recessive alleles will not be able to express themselves. So all the progenies of F1 generation will be round and yellow, but they will be heterozygous. Now when we self them, self means, now when we take two plants from F1 generation, see, two plants, and when we cross them, so now we have taken parents from this generation, and now when we have crossed them, so what are the options of gametes I can get? See, either capital R combines with capital Y, this one, or capital R can combine with small y, this one, or small r can combine with capital Y, this one, or small r can combine with small y, this one. So beyond these four options, I won't get any other gimme. So we have written all the probabilities or options. Similarly here, I will get all the options here, right? So you see, now if I draw such kind of lines for this cross, it will be too messy. So to avoid that, we make a Punnett square. This is our Punnett square. So in this Punnett square for F2 generation, we have written the gametes here for the parents. These are the parents. This parent is written here and the other parent is written here. One is male and the other one is female. Now both the parents are written here. Now when they combine, now you see this R combines with this RY. So what is the result we are getting? Capital R, capital Y, that means homozygous round yellow. But if this R combines with this gamete, so what are we getting? Though we are getting round yellow, but the genotype is different. Similarly, when this R combines with this option, I am getting the same result in phenotype, but the genes are different. And when I combine this with this, again the result or the phenotype is same, but genotypes are different. So we will write all the options here in the box of Punnett square and the results will be recorded. And when I'll count the number of phenotypes here, so how many round yellow will I get, or how many round green will I get, or how many wrinkled yellow will I get and wrinkled green. If I count here all the phenotypes, you see what am I getting? I'm getting 9:3:3:1. That means now 9 round yellow, you can count it here, 9 round yellow, 3 round green, 3 wrinkled green and 3 wrinkled yellow and 1 wrinkled green. So my ratio will be 9:3:3:1. Okay, so this is what is being done here when they count. So this was the dihybrid cross. And if we count the genotypic ratio, children, this is the genotypic ratio. See, because in genotypic ratio, we will count the number of different genes. Like capital R, capital Y is only one type. Similarly, capital R's and one capital Y, one small type is of two. They are of two in number and so on. So what is the genotypic ratio? This is the genotypic ratio that we are getting. And this one is the phenotypic ratio of dihybrid cross. So this was what is dihybrid cross.